Thank you for joining us. In this video, I'd like to go over how the new advanced search and advanced browse features work. Now, these work with form list views, new ways for your site visitors to query or browse your form data. So let me go ahead and jump in here. I've got an example here. This is a forum page, and you'll notice there's a search box here, and this is what we call basic search. So you could do a keyword search here. So if you search for dude, you'd find that it's going to find this one result, which is nice forum dude. And you'll notice we've enhanced the search box features. You now have all the actions or navigation built inside the field. This makes them operate better within mobile device environments. So here's a basic search. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put edit mode on, and I'm going to go inside my form list view, which is where I set the advanced search and browse features. And I'm going to go down here to the bottom. You'll notice here's my search, which is enabled. And now I have the ability to enable my advanced search. I'm going to go ahead and check that. Now you notice it gives me some new options. And a couple things I can do, I can expand that advanced search by default. But you'll also notice here that there's this rich text area here, and I can select anything I want from here. I can select all the form fields I've created or any system fields, and I can drop them in here, lay them out however I want them. I can also size, you know, the field to how big I want that field to be. I can also place the submit and clear buttons anywhere I want within the panel that's going to be displayed. And down here at the bottom, I also have a little trick here. I've got a mobile version too, because I want a little bit different layout and a different advanced search for my mobile visitors. So that's down here at the bottom. And this is all, of course, hidden from the desktop users. And that's all done using the mobile hide custom formats. I've got basically a layout here for this panel. I'm going to go ahead and save this so I can show you how this looks. Now you'll notice now on my page, my search box now has a little plus next to it, and this lets me know that I have advanced search on this page. When I click on that, you'll see now there's a panel of all those fields I was showing. You can expand that, and they can actually search for any of those. And of course, if you have pick lists within your data, that will automatically become pick lists here on the page. So you can see that information is there. I can also have my data displayed by default or not displayed. So if I just want to have a search box on the page or a big search form, I could do that. The keyword search still works here. So I type in a keyword that works in addition to these other features here that are on that. If I close that, it'll send that up and out of the way. So that's how advanced search works. And again, like I said, this is all mobile ready. I'm going to go back in here and edit this. I'm going to go ahead and turn on my advanced browse and show you that. So down here below the advanced search is enable browse, and I have some options here. I can decide to by default expand one of them or not, and then I can select the different fields that are in my form data that I want to display and how many columns I want to display those. I'll go ahead and save that. I'm going to go ahead and take the grid mode off. It'll be easier to see this. You can see now that I've got this browse on this side, which I can completely close if I want. So there's my browse and there's my search. You could leave these like this by default. You could open either one of these by default. In this case, if I search by topic, what I can do is I can click on all topic one, and it's going to show me all of the forum posts that have been filed under that topic. So this gives your users a way to search and find information either through a browse metaphor or a search metaphor. And again, all this works great on mobile. So if I go into mobile mode, you'll see that I've got my browse and my search here. And we move this up and out of the way so you can see this a little easier. I have my search panel here too. And you'll notice now this is my mobile search panel, not my desktop panel. So you have that capability there. And let me show you a couple of different applications for this. Obviously, a forum is a good application for both the advanced search and advanced browse, but there are some others. So for example, under my blog, I might want to categorize my blog postings and people could search by that. I might have tags for my blog postings so they could browse by the different tags as well. And of course, I can have basic search enabled with browse together on the same page. Here's another example, staff directory, and I can have them all by default. My advanced browse is open alphabetically. Now you're going to wonder, well, you know, there's some of these letters are missing here. Where did they go? Well, that's just because there's nobody in the staff directory that has a name, for example, a name with a C. So it's not going to show any data that doesn't exist in the database. Of course, you can also, again, here's an example of the advanced search. So if they wanted to search by name, they could do that as well. Here's an example of support tickets. Let's say, for example, that you didn't want to show all this information by default. Then you could go inside this form list view here, go down here to my search, and I could say I don't want to show results by default. So if I do that, then you'll notice here that I just have a search box. So that's still not a complete solution. Let's go and enable advanced search so that they see what they need to do when they first go to the page. So now you'll see that if you wanted to, you could have an application where they search for a ticket. So you could have a search like this where they just type in the ticket number and search, and then it will show the results. So there's a lot of different kinds of applications that you can do. You can drop these here on this page. You can put them in a sidebar. You can include multiple views within a page. So if you had several different types of data, you wanted them all on one page, you can certainly do that. So you're not bound by this one feature working only on one page of your site. So you can spread it around and have some fun with it. So hopefully this helps you get a little bit more understanding about how you can use the new advanced search and advanced browse features to make your data more accessible to your visitors. Hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.